Hey guys, David Lagori with Lagori Drag Racing. And a lot of kits that I sell this MSD relay. And that's what the video is over today, is how to wire it, what are the uses for it, and why I use it. So I use this a lot because it's easier to wire than a regular conventional relay. It's solid state, so you can progress a nitrous solenoid through it. And it is four relays in one package. Okay, so you have a battery terminal here, you have two outputs here, and these are your activation terminals. You can activate with 12 volts or ground. The way you mount it is there's these little squares on the side, and you slide these pucks, these mounting pucks, over it and use a bolt to secure it. You can put those pucks on either way you want, so you can mount it flat, upright, upside down, so forth. So a little bit of a nice convenience there that you can mount it in each direction. This battery terminal here, you connect that to your 12 volts. Connect that directly to your battery. I usually use about a 8-gauge welding wire, something like that, maybe a 10-gauge. You want something pretty heavy going in there. Each of your outputs, your four outputs on these medium-sized lugs, are 12-volt outputs. So when you connect a fuel pump to it, you're going to run a wire from your MSD relay out to your fuel pump. And that is going to be your 12 volt positive to your fuel pump. On the other side of your fuel pump, you need to ground it to the battery. This relay has over amperage protection. This specific relay is 20 amps. So if it goes over 20 amps on any of these outputs, it will shut that output off. They make a 35 amp. I've never personally had to use a 35 amp. I've always used the 20 amp and never had an issue. If you have an extra lead, you can double these up for twice the amps. So let's get into how I actually wire these. So on a motorcycle, we have a tether, we have a toggle switch normally, and a start button. So the way that I wire this, run a battery lead from your battery positive to the battery terminal on here. It says bat here also. And I also take a 18-gauge wire out of the battery terminal and I'll go to my tether switch. Out of my tether switch, I branch those wires off. So I make it two wires. So I'm actually going to grab a piece of paper and I'm going to draw it also. Okay, so I got this drawing and I hope everybody can see it. So on this relay, I have 12 volts coming in from my battery. And then I have another wire on my battery going to my tether switch. Out of my tether, I'm branching off into two wires. One is going to the incoming side of my start button, and the other is going to the incoming side of the on and off switch, on and off toggle switch. Out of the start button goes to the start relay, and you also have to ground the relay in order for the relay to work. Out of the on and off switch, I have it coming back to this top terminal here, and it's the top 12 volt activation side. So on the relay, it's the top side is 12 volt activation, bottom side is ground. This last ground, because there's five on there, has to be a ground. It has to go to battery ground. You can see that I have ground here. If you don't have that, the relay will not work. So you can see on this drawing, when it comes back here and activates that terminal, when I turn the power switch on to the bike, it's going to activate this lug here. That lug, I put all of my switch power on. So anything that I want on, when I turn the on switch on, for ECU lights, like a tail light, front light, coils, injector power, anything that you want on with switch power must be on that terminal. On these drawings, I will post a still photo into this video so that you guys can screenshot it with your phone or take a picture of your computer screen, whatever you need. So how do you wire the fuel pump? So from a Fuel Tech ECU, you are going to run a blue output from Fuel Tech to a grounding side lug. And when the Fuel Tech sends ground for the fuel pump, it will turn on the corresponding lug and it will turn on the 12 volts to the fuel pump, and you have to ground the other side. So I'll take a still shot of this and post it into this video. Also, you're gonna do the same thing with nitrous solenoids, fans, anything that's over 5 amps needs a relay. So if you're controlling something with a high amperage, you want a relay. So I hope this is a good overview of how I wire my switch power, my fuel pumps, my nitrous solenoids. You can have 4 stages of nitrous solenoids on this thing. It doesn't matter. But it's a very nice packaged unit, and a lot easier to wire than a conventional relay. And it's a lot easier to tell you how to wire it also. So hope you like this video. There's a lot of guys on here that aren't subscribed, so please subscribe. It helps a crazy amount with how things work on this app. So please subscribe. Thanks.